Jatayu, the great vulture. Sita wept bitterly as Ravana carried her in his chariot. She was cursing herself for sending Rama to hunt the deer and for not obeying Lakshman's instruction. King of vultures, Jatayu heard her cry and recognized at once that she was Sita, Rama's wife. He shouted and consoled Sita not to worry, as he would kill the foolish demon. He flew towards the chariot with a great speed. Ravana saw him flying towards him. He recognized and laughingly shouted that he would defeat the old vulture with a single punch of his hand. Hearing this, Jatayu became angry and warned Ravana to return Sita. Otherwise, he would have to incur the wrath of Lord Rama. But Ravana refused to return Sita. Jatayu rushed towards him. He held Ravana by the hair and pushed him down from the chariot. Jatayu took Sita down from the chariot. He started hurting Ravana by attacking him with his beak. Ravana initially fainted but regained his senses sometime. Thereafter, he took out his sword and cut off Jatayu's wings. Jatayu fell on the ground crying in pain. Ravana put Sita back on his chariot and flew to Lanka. Ravana takes Sita to Ashokavan. After injuring Jatayu, Ravan put Sita back on his chariot and started flying towards Lanka. Sita was even more terrified now. She shouted for help, but to no avail. Soon Ravana was flying high in the sky towards his capital city of Lanka. The cry of Sita's help could not reach distant Rama and Lakshman. Sita was weeping bitterly. The chariot flew over a mountain where Sita saw some monkeys. She yelled out the name of her husband, Rama, and tied some of her ornaments in a piece of cloth. She threw the cloth down towards the monkeys to be given to Rama as a clue of her wife. Ravana's chariot then reached Lanka. He tried to persuade Sita to marry him and live with him in his palace. He even tried to frighten her, but she did not agree and kept on weeping. So he took Sita to Ashokavan. He dropped her under an Ashoka tree and made all arrangements for her living there. He appointed some of his faithful horrible she-demons to look after and take care of Sita. She lived there unhappily and was always lost in the memories of her husband Rama. Search for Sita. Marij had screamed in Rama's voice before dying. So thinking about Sita and Lakshman's worry, Rama hurried towards his cottage. But he was shocked to meet Lakshman on the way. He was angry with Lakshman for leaving Sita alone in the forest. Lakshman apologized for his mistake and told about Sita's insistence in sending him to help Rama. The brothers rushed towards the cottage. After reaching the cottage, they were shocked to see that Sita was not there. The cottage was empty. There was no space around their cottage, which they did not visit repeatedly above and to the back of the hill within the neighboring forest and by the river, calling Sita's name aloud. They thoroughly searched all the places, but Sita was not found. Rama was going out of his mind in grief. Tears rolled down his cheeks. He touched her paintings and the impressions of her hands on the walls. He put his head against them and cried bitterly. Tired and exhausted, he threw himself on a rock and broke down. He was devastated as he started calling Sita again and again. He was deeply missing his dear wife Sita. Rama in Shabri's ashram. Rama and Lakshman saw the injured Jatayu while searching for Sita. He told Rama that Ravana had kidnapped Sita and had gone towards the south. He died after saying this. Rama performed the rituals of his funeral and headed south. They reached Shabri's cottage. Shabri was a tribal woman. Sage Matang had once told her that Rama would visit her one day. Many years passed by and Shabri grew old. Each day she cleaned her cottage and waited patiently for Rama to visit her. Finally, Rama and Lakshman had arrived at her cottage. Shabri was overjoyed. She washed their feet lovingly. She had collected berries for Rama. She tasted every berry and kept aside the sweetest of them for her lord. Lakshman was shocked to see Shabri offering fruits that she herself had tasted before offering to Rama. But Rama explained to Lakshman that tasting the berries before giving them to him to eat showed Shabri's love and devotion. Rama was happy to accept the sincere offerings and blessed the old lady for her pity. Shabri felt that her greatest desire had been fulfilled by meeting her lord. Asking Rama to grant her salvation, she entered the fire.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.